Ah, you're out in the garden on a lovely summer day when you spot a yellow fluffy caterpillar crawling on a leaf. You look closer and notice it has 5 black tufts of longer hair sticking out. You think, how cute, and reach out to pet the fuzzy little guy. But hold it right there. That's an American dagger, and it's anything but harmless. Those seemingly soft, pleasant hairs are more like stingers. When they get embedded in your skin, it causes a painful rash and welts. It's not like a bee sting either. This bug's venom builds up slowly. Eh, still want to touch it? Yeah, I thought so. Scarier than that is a puss caterpillar. You'll know immediately when this one gets its fluffy hairs in you. It feels worse than a bee sting. Then comes the rash, swelling, fever, and even muscle cramps and joint pain. It's the most poisonous caterpillar in the US. Young ones are yellow, and they get browner and hairier as they grow. The saddleback caterpillar looks like something from another planet. Also known as a slug caterpillar, they have pom-poms all over their bodies. Kind of like fuzzy cheerleaders. Those pom-poms are densely covered with hairs, containing a pretty powerful poison. If you get to touch this caterpillar, swelling, rash, and probably even nausea are guaranteed for a few days. The hag moth looks more like a spider than a caterpillar. All those arm-like tentacles coming out of its sides are covered in venomous hairs. One touch can leave you with painful irritation. If you ever catch any fuzzy caterpillar crawling on you, don't remove it with your fingers. Grab a pair of tweezers. If one manages to sting you, gently put tape on the side and peel it off to get all the hairs out. Just don't use the same piece of tape twice. You could end up sticking a hair back into yourself. Wash the area with soap and water and use an anti-itch cream if you need. Okay, enough of these hairy hair raisers. Let's head to the beach. But a peaceful shell collecting trip can end in a nightmare if you accidentally pick up a cone snail. When hunting or defending themselves, these snails shoot a needle-like harpoon through the pointy end of its shell. It's full of enough venom for 20 adults. The poison paralyzes the prey, also causing double vision, troubles breathing, and of course, severe pain. Pufferfish blow themselves up to survive in the wild. When they're in balloon mode with all those spikes standing straight up, other animals can't eat them as easily. Not that it's safer to dine on one when it's deflated. This fish's poison is over 1,000 times more toxic than cyanide. Don't count on an antidote to save you. It doesn't exist yet. Okay, we'll avoid that one. A colorful blue-ringed octopus is no bigger than a chicken egg, but it poses serious danger to any living thing it meets. Their stings are surprisingly painless, so it can even go unnoticed at first. Even though the venom contains the happy hormone dopamine, it'll make you anything but joyful. Respiratory failure can come within 10 minutes. One more problem? There's no antidote. The Irukandji jellyfish may be smaller than an inch, but even the strongest pain relievers in the world won't help if one stings you. The symptoms can take up to an hour to fully kick in, and they include severe muscle aches and pain, nausea, and breathing problems. Its venom is almost 100 times stronger than a cobra's. And yeah, no anti-venom yet for this one either. But the box jellyfish has the most potent venom in the world. The creature is pretty large, yet people may not notice it since it's see-through. The jellyfish grabs onto its prey with all those toxic tentacles. The poison is enough for 60 grown people, so invite your friends. Not many can brag of surviving a rendezvous with this jelly. Okay, scratch that beach trip. Hey, let's look at the skies. You wouldn't expect a bird on this list, but alas, I bring to you the hooded pitahui. Scientists found that they're venomous when they kept experiencing numbness and a burning sensation after handling these birds. There are lots of toxins in its feathers, especially on the underside. The birds don't produce toxins themselves. They probably get them from the beetles they eat. Or how about the spur-winged goose? Again, these birds don't produce any toxins themselves. They get it from their diet of blister beetles. It's safe to touch them, but eating one can lead to irreversible consequences. Wink, wink. The toxin remains even after cooking. Mute swans are gorgeous, graceful creatures. At least, that's what we all think. But touching one of these birds is a bad idea. They have bony spurs in their wings they use to take enemies out. Well, at least there's no venom. They also bite. Don't ever get too close to one. They regularly go after humans, especially if the bird has younglings nearby. And don't let the name fool you either. They aren't mute. Swans can hiss loudly and even bark. Good warning signs that you're encroaching too close. Ah, slow lorises with their big, adorable eyes. You know better by now. These cuties are more dangerous than they appear. Like me. Nah, just kidding. They're the only venomous primate in the world. They bite with a mouth full of toxic saliva. And get this, they go into a defense position by putting their arms up around their head. Scientists believe they do this as a way of mimicking cobras. To us humans, their defensive stance looks like a shy little creature trying to hide its face. In reality, it's warning you that a bite is coming. The duck-billed platypus lays eggs, which is pretty uncommon for mammals. They also have venom glands, even more uncommon. They deliver their toxin through small, spur-like stingers on the heels of their hind feet. The venom is harmless for humans, but a sting is painful and often swells at the site. Surprisingly, the southern short-tailed shrew has some venom too. It's not powerful enough to seriously harm a human, but it's sure to cause muscle problems and swelling. One shrew bite has enough venom to take down 200 mice and can even be harmful to cats. They inject the paralyzing venom with their grooved teeth. Raccoons may not have any venom like others on the list, but they carry something that can be even more dangerous – disease. Trash makes up part of these guys' diet, so they're best left untouched. Although they're usually shy and will retreat when people come nearby, it's their notorious bite and scratches that can get you sick. Catfish look goofy and harmless, but the spines in their dorsal and pectoral fins do contain venom. When it gets into your skin, a painful sting by the way, the poison causes intense swelling that can even lead to tissue loss. Scientists believe there are more than 1,600 species of venomous catfish. Meow. The bright, beautiful colors of a poison dart frog serve as a warning. Don't touch. One frog has enough poison for 20,000 mice. Another reason to be glad that you're not a mouse. They slurp termites and crickets with a long, sticky tongue. They also love small beetles. And scientists think it's the beetle diet that makes these frogs one of the most toxic animals on the planet. Komodo dragons are the largest lizard in the world. But they don't have only size on their side. Their saliva is poisonous and can cause infections. They deliver it thanks to razor-sharp teeth. They don't attack humans very often, but there have been a few serious cases. Another venomous lizard is the Gila monster. Thanks to its sluggishness, this lizard doesn't pose much danger to humans. You'd have enough time to run away. People used to believe the lizard has toxic breath, but it's actually venom glands in its lower jaw. A journalist was once bitten by a Gila monster, and he described it as one of the most painful bites he'd ever gotten, comparing it to hot lava. He was also bitten by hot lava? Wow! One seemingly harmless little critter holds a Guinness World Record. Meet the most dangerous ant in the world, the bulldog ant. Nearly the length of a matchstick, this Australian ant attacks using its massive pincher-like jaws and a stinger on the back at the same time. Its venom can take down a full-grown person in just 15 minutes. Next to that thing, a kissing bug doesn't seem so scary. But don't be fooled. Also known as vampire bugs, these parasites like to dine on the same thing mosquitoes enjoy. Blood. Their bite is venomless, but it is full of proteins that can cause a severe allergic reaction in people. Worse still is that they like to aim at the lips and mouth area. Well, pucker up. Wait, better yet, don't.